Klits Antoniou's project, The Persistence of the Image, curated by Gabriel Koureas, resulted from the collaboration of the artists with 85 artists, architects, designers, sociologists, art historians, and art students who live in Cyprus and were asked to work on a photograph of the Halal Sultan Tekke in Larnaca. Antoniou's choice is pertinent within the Cypriot context and the often contradictory meanings and memories associated with images depending on which side of the dividing line one speaks from. Most importantly, the work engages with the Ottoman past of the island, which has been either erased from the memory cultures of the Greek-speaking population, or it is included, or it is if it is included, it is remembered as a black period in Cypriot history. Central to the artwork is Yavartis Spivak's argument that one needs to remember the constructed nature of modern nationalism in the Middle East, and which effaced the recently negotiated multinationality that formed the Ottoman Empire. The major problem in the Cypriot case when considering Spivak's argument is that the island is often not included either historically or geographically in the Middle East, but tends to be aligned to the glorified European tradition with its roots in the classical ancient Greek civilization, thus bypassing the Ottoman period. This has often detrimental consequences for our understanding of the nationalists that marked the history of Cyprus and its post-colonial era. What we can learn from the Ottoman past is that the cities of the Ottoman Empire were multiple and multicultural, and this past history is highly contemporarily relevant. What these cities demonstrate is a cosmopolitan city world of the Ottoman Empire and their transcultural memory, thus revealing the wealth of exchange between different Ottoman city cultural groups, whether these were Greek, Turkish, Armenian, or Jewish, to name just a few, and the respective of religious affiliations, Christian or Muslim. The cosmopolitan memories of the Ottoman past have much to teach us about our present multicultural world, and especially post-colonial nationalism and religious fanatism. The transcultural memories of the Ottoman past have contemporary importance in light of the nationalism that are debated in the media and Middle East conflicts, as present artificially imposed separations are preceded by Ottoman heterogeneity. These memories speak against current divisions. At the same time, we know also that practice cosmopolitanism is no idea, as we need to consider how objects, people, and concepts are contrived or placed under a region in order to examine what Spitzer called the post-memories of diasporas. The collaboration combined archival work with the practice of making and reading photographs, memories, and novels, where text and image often work together, as in Orhan Pamuk's Istanbul Memories of a City of 2005. The inextricable link between melancholy and nostalgia when contemplating a lost Ottoman past from the present city is perhaps best expressed through the visual medium of photography. Photography has played a key role in our research methodology and collaboration. What our collaboration is also engaging with is the relationship of memory and photography, and the argument put forward by Walter Benjamin that other commentators that photography creates a false or counter memory, which results in what Sontag calls the replacement of memory by a photograph. Memory, wrote Benjamin, is not an instrument for the exploration of the past, but rather its theater, the medium of what has been experienced, as the earth is the medium in which cities lie buried in debris. Most importantly, for Benjamin, facts are only layers. Which deliver the true assets hidden within the inner earth, the images which stand like ruins as the treasures of the prosaic chambers of our belated insights. One could accuse the collaboration of nostalgia for a past that no longer exists, and for seeing the Ottoman Empire through the tinted lens that purifies its history and the wars and destructions that it instigated. Nostalgia has been seen by social commentators as a social disease, or as Lana Cohen argues, a nostalgic desire to obliterate history and turn it into private or collective mythology. to revisit time like space, refusing to surrender to the irreversibility of time that plagues the human condition. It might appear that our collaboration is adopting this nostalgic mode without insistence in revisiting time through the space of photography. However, as Bohm continues to argue, nostalgia is about the relationship between individual biography and the biography of groups and nations, between personal and collective memory. And she distinguishes between restorative nostalgia, which attempts a transhistorical reconstruction of the lost home as evidence of truth and tradition. By contrast, reflective nostalgia is about the longing itself and concentrates on challenging the idea of absolute truth. Most importantly for Bohm, reflective nostalgia allows us to distinguish between national memory that is based on a single plot of national identity and social memory, which consists of collective frameworks that mark but not define the individual memory. Reflective nostalgia does this by lingering on ruins, the patina of time and history, in the dreams of another time and place. Without restorative nostalgia has no use for the science of historical time, patina, ruins, cracks, imperfections. Returning to the artwork of Teke, which was constructed in its present form in the early 19th century and was dedicated to the memory of Mohammed's wet nurse, Balat Sultan, who died falling from her mule during the first Arab raids in Cyprus in the 7th century, presents a space of contestation between Islamic and Christian cultures. By many, it's considered as the third most important religious Islamic site, although it is strongly contested by certain Islamic groups. Although evidence exists as to the site's syncretic appeal throughout the Ottoman occupation of the island, all Christian and especially Greek Orthodox sources try to downplay or refute this by this very important function of the site. Hence, Antoniou's artistic intervention takes an important role in challenging such hegemonic notions in order to provide the possibility of mediation through reflective nostalgia. The numerous memories that the participants to the project brought to the image testify to multiplicity of meanings and interpretations that move away from monolithic interpretations of the site, thus questioning the instrumentalization of history and the perceived dichotomies, geographical, political, religious, ideological, associated with it. The space of the Teke, a favorite school excursion outing for Greek Cypriot students in its romantic setting at the edge of the Larnaca Salt Lake, provides a double-edged attraction. On the one hand, it is seductive through the sheer beauty of the landscape, and on the other hand, it is forbidden, a forbidden space that represents the other within the Greek Cypriot community of the island. The technique of the artist uses managed to animate these inherent contradictions of the space of the Teke. Through the animation of the interventions to the image of the Teke and their asynchronous projection on four gigantic books, accompanied by the insistent piercing sound of turning pages, the projection represents the Freudian idea of screen memories, which according to Freud are not childhood memories as such, but memories about childhood. Important facts are not retained, instead their psychic insignificance is displaced onto closely associated but less important details. Freud elaborated on the idea of screen memories in another essay where he compares screen memories with dreams, arguing that their common trait is visual representability, similar to that of mnemic symbols and images. It is exactly these symbols and images, whether these are storks that used to frequent the Salt Lake and found on a number of interventions to the image, or flying angels and aeroplanes that form the major part of the projected interventions. The screens, the books of hegemonic histories from both sides of the Cypriot conflict are animated with the screen memories of the individual interventions in order to reinterpret the histories and create a space that allows alternative narratives to emerge. However, the image of the Teke persists through the projection, refusing to be erased, reminding us of the Ottoman history of the island and its geographical positioning within the Middle East, as well as the cultural memory associated with such positioning. The symbols and images that flicker in front of our eyes provide a visual representability that reminds us that looking east might be an alternative to looking west.